Hendo, and today we're going to do a little showcase and review of CostGear's CostTail and CostBand Pro. I'll show you 6 different ways to make horns and tails based on different looks from Hero Forge. CostGear is sponsoring this video, and I can't tell you how stoked I am that I genuinely really like the products and the company. I'll go into more detail about the CostTail and CostBand later in the video when I do a full review, but I want to start with just showing off the versatility. For now, all you need to know is that CostGear is solving all of my cosplay problems with science. This is a robotic tail that's really lively with both dynamic and static movement. And the headband allows you to attach a bunch of accessories to yourself using magnets. These are the different types of horns, tails, and accessories that we're gonna make, and I'm gonna style them with 5 different classes from D&D. All of them will be based on my current pink tiefling, Karen McSharon. All of these sections are also timestamped below, so let's get cosplaying. I'm gonna be ready to go once events finally happen again. First up, I wanted to make the smooth spiral horns. This is kind of the default shape I think of whenever I think of a tiefling. I'm gonna do this in both a smooth and a ridge style because why not? And also because I couldn't make up my mind. I'm using 4mm craft foam and barge glue, assembling it, and then sanding all the edges down. For the ridge horns, I'm actually gonna Dremel in the texture before I assemble them. The magnets provided are pretty strong, but the wig is gonna create a little bit of a separation between the magnet and your accessory, so it's best to keep it as lightweight as possible and to use strong magnets. The CostBand Pro comes in this cute little bag and it's super simple to use. It comes with extra magnets, but you can also order more from CostGear's website or get your own neodymium or rare earth magnets too. Super glue should be enough to hold the magnet to the horn, but just to make sure that the magnet doesn't just rip off, I'm gonna have that on the inside of the foam and then glue it shut. A little masking tape can also help make sure that the magnet stays in place. I'm making sure I know which orientation the charge on the magnet should be to match the headband, then I'm going to go ahead and glue it down to the foam. Now I'm cutting and sanding off the excess, and it's time for my first magnetic horns test. I love that I can twist the horns around in whatever direction I want since they're just magnetically attached. This gives me a lot more versatility compared to the headband method. I'm sorry, I don't know why I'm so excited about these magnets. I'm really stoked that a random company in Norway is actually sponsoring me to play with this. My tiefling is also part of a 4 tiefling punk metal band called Dank, so these horns also have to be headbanger proof. They're kind of perfect and I'm really excited. Now I'm gonna slap some magnets on those ridged spiral horns too. Then both pairs are getting some sanding, heat sealing, filling, and painting. The ridged horns are gonna get a little layer of lighter pink acrylic paint, and I'm just brushing that lightly on the edges to help define the texture. And my smooth spiral horns are just getting a bit of a light pink ombre. I made a few accessories to spice up the horns, and it looks like I'm ready to hit the town as a pink tiefling rogue. Take a look at this tail. This is the straight tail design from Hero Forge. It's your basic demon tail. And let's go ahead and unbox the cost tail. I really like the compact packaging and the fact that it comes with an extra segment and a bunch of extra wires. It does require you to assemble the tail, but it's also like super easy and they have a whole tutorial on their own YouTube. It's also just kind of intuitive. You just alternate the little pieces. There should be 19 in total. Remove your annoying cat and feed the steel wire through all of the little segments. The only part I struggled with was inserting the wire, and that was just because the little knob was already tightened, so I needed to loosen it in order for the wire to fit in. Once I figured that out, I popped the wire in, added the string, calibrated it, and tied the strings off. The CostTail also comes with a power bank and a connecting wire. It looks a little different from their YouTube video because it's been updated now, it's a little bit more compact, and the on-off switch is just on the power bank. Once for on, twice for off. The tail and its component box are completely detachable from the harness, which comes with a strap and has room for an extra strap. It's fairly easy to sit in anyway, but I really like that I can just easily reach around and take it off if I need to sit or drive somewhere. Something I really love about this tail is the pause mode. It's so cute when it moves even though you're standing still. It's very subtle and natural. It just feels like it's part of you. I can't wait to take it to Ren Faire because people always comment on how cool it looks just when I'm standing still. Okay, side note, I met with Vetle from CostGear, he's the marketing guy, and he actually said that the engineers only took like a few hours to program pause mode compared to the tail moving when you're moving dynamically, and they were just kind of surprised that The thing that only took them a few hours is one of the main features that people love about their product. Every creator knows that struggle. Okay, anyway, since the tail needs the flexibility to move side to side, I can't have the cover wrap too tightly and restrict the movement. It doesn't have to have a ton of room, just enough for it to move around. I made a sleeve for my tail so that I could pad it out and put any cover I want on top of it instead of needing each cover to have that insulation padding. I'm taking the slippery lining fabric and making a cover layer. Then I'm taking this batting and hot gluing it to the cover. And now a slightly larger cover, which I'm gonna toss inside out and put on top of the batting. Now that I have this sandwich of lining, insulation, and lining, I'm gonna go ahead and seal it with some bias tape and Velcro. Now I made a simple cover out of my PVC fabric, and I'm gonna go ahead and spray that so that it has an ombre that matches my horns. And I'm adding little spots and freckles with a toothbrush in various shades of pink. I really like how it turned out, and it matches my horns perfectly. I wanted to try out a few other horn shapes too. I feel like the ridge dragon horns on Hero Forge are a shape I see in media a lot, like either straight up like Maleficent or straight back like Spyro. And now that my horns are magnetic, I can orient them whichever direction I'd like and I have the versatility. I'm gonna make these out of foam too, using the foil and duct tape method in order to create my pattern. This is gonna provide the base shape, and I'm gonna solder a little bit of grain texture into the very tip. And now I'm adding ridge, stepwise layers that are soldered with grain too. After a little cleanup, I'm gonna paint them dark pink, and then brush a light pink on top of the ridges just to bring out that texture a bit again. And blam, I've got some ridge dragon horns. I think these will look super good as a paladin.
Enchanté.
Isn't the only way to make horns, and probably one of the easiest methods is to just make the base shape out of aluminum foil and cover it with foam clay or model magic. I'm gonna aim for the archdemon horn shape, but a little bit smaller. Make sure that when you insert the magnet and cover it in clay, that you keep it away from anything that might rip the magnet out before the clay has a chance to dry. Once it does, you should be all good. I'm gonna sand it down, Dremel in and solder some texture, and then heat seal it. I'm also gonna paint them all up nice and pink to match, and this shape just sort of screams druid to me, so I decided to hot glue on some moss and flowers to give it that one with nature look. Time to get druidic. Is that druidy? Time to get druidy. Druid! It's time to druid. So at this point, Costgear has basically shown me that everything can be solved with magnets. So I decided it might be nice to have some detachable magnetic spikes and make the silhouette look like the demon tail from Hero Forge. I emailed Vitle and asked him if adding magnets to the tail sections would create any sort of issue with the electronics. He said all of the electronics are up in the box at the base of the tail, so adding them to the segment should be fine. All clear. So I have these small but strong magnets, and I'm just adding them to three of the little tail segments at the bottom. and making sure they all have the same charge facing up. And now I'm making a quick little dragon tail sleeve. I think this is Yagyo Han fabric, and it also comes in blue-green. Just a super easy way to get a dragon tail texture. I'm also adding some ribbon and jewelry to the end and covering that with Velcro. For the spikes, I'm actually gonna use cake decorating tips. The little hole at the top should be so small that you don't even see it, and each one costs less than a dollar. This is a trick that I learned from another cosplayer, but I don't remember if it was Nightmage or Canvas cosplay. Cosplayers are geniuses. The very end of the tail is gonna end in a spike, so I'm just hot gluing that one on. The other tips are gonna get foam clay to fill up most of the tip, and then a bit of hot glue, the magnet in the right direction, and a little more hot glue on top to seal it off. And boop, boop, boop. Here they all are. This is gonna be extra nice for storage, and if I want the spikes in different places, I can just move around that particular segment with a magnet. Let's take it for a test drive. And hey, if you don't feel like crafting, you can also just buy some horns and easily glue a magnet onto them. Hair clips are always so slippery and annoying. I'm so glad I can rip these off and use magnets instead. I got these Bowser horns that are pretty similar to the Hero Forge bull horns. I'm gonna go ahead and make a little sleeve out of my same fabric so that it matches my tail. But you can easily just paint them or leave them how they are. I'm making a little pattern, sewing it, and decorating the base so it'll blend a little bit easier with my hairline. And boom, that took me like 10 minutes compared to the other horns. And they perfectly match my tail. They're very sparkly and ethereal, but also don't mess with them, so perfect for a cleric. Me thinking that I would love to have more accessories be magnetic too. It's so much easier to brush my wig or reposition my hair when it's a straight magnetic attachment instead of a headband or clips or whatever else is messing up my hair that I have to completely remove in order to fix it all. Flower crowns have been especially annoying to me because I feel like the size that I need varies depending on the thickness of my wig. It never really completely fits all of my different wigs or hairstyles. Plus, the flowers always tangle my hair, so it's gonna be so nice to have an easy magnetic fix. This method might also be good for silhouettes that don't go completely around your head. I'm basically making a flower crown with the normal method, using a wire, floral tape, and flowers. And I'm just gonna attach two magnets at the front disguised as leaves. I don't have to worry about the charge orientation since it's pretty easy to just twist the leaves around whichever direction I need. Extra easy. And kablam! Look how easy it is for me to just brush my hair and attach the crown. Yup. Okay, clearly I can make a zillion things for my cos gear, but the last thing I'm gonna make is just a normal fur tail, which probably looks the closest to the canine tail on Hero Forge. Working with fur is a little bit tedious since you have to cut and prep it differently, but if you don't feel like you're in the mood for that, you can go ahead and check out cos gear's selection of tails too. I just wanted a simple brown fur tail that'll match my cat ears. Some cutting, pinning, and stitching later, boom, I have a cute little fluffy tail. Most fur fabric also has enough of a textured backing that you can go ahead and just hot glue on the Velcro. And this will avoid a visible stitch. Oh, and at this point I made like a zillion tails, and I'm kind of surprised that the super glued on Velcro is actually holding up really well. I think it's just really lucky that the electronic box has a little bit of a texture to it, so the glue sticks. It's either lucky or genius, I don't know. The fur is also so fluffy that I don't really need to worry about the shape or using my insulation sleeve. I can just go ahead and slap that bad boy on there. Adding a little bit of ribbon or flair to your tail will also help accentuate the movement, and it just looks super cute. I don't really know what class I'm aiming for here, I'm just aiming for cute, cuddly class. Maybe a bard, I don't know. Thank you. you've seen some of the ways I've utilized my COS gear, let's go ahead and do a little review. The COS Band Pro is super versatile and absolutely worth the price, especially since it comes with extra magnets and a pair of cat ears. I'm so glad that they chose an elastic wrap instead of a connected elastic band. It can be as tight as you like, which is really nice for me because I tend to get a bit of a headache if like my wig or wig cap is too tight. So it's customizable and fits all sizes and hair lengths. The velvety side is also super considerate since it doesn't tend to pull your hair much at all. It's also so important that it's elastic. Things tend to just sort of shift around under your wig, and just a little bit of flex makes sure that the magnets stay in place. I also really like that the magnetic part of the headband is essentially a pocket, so if you accidentally glue the magnet the wrong direction on your accessory, you aren't completely screwed. You can just flip the headband around or reach in and flip one of the magnets that's giving you a hard time. I especially love that they aren't locked into a position, so you can move them around as much as you need to. I also didn't notice this until now, but there is a little stitch down the center so that the two magnets don't accidentally connect and fold onto each other and just be really difficult to take apart. You can also add even more magnets if you'd like to and double up on horns or horns and ears or whatever. You can also just use that strong magnetic attachment to be able to affix things like hats or even a cape. Now I can use the hood to my capes without having to cut a hole for the horns. Booyah. It also comes with this nice little bag that makes it very easy to pack and store. Since it's such an affordable price, I could also see it becoming a staple of cosplay. They have lots of pre-made options available in their store, and I can't wait to see how other cosplayers utilize this as well. Okay, now the COS tail, which I heckin' love. It's incredibly easy to assemble, and I really like that they have a video guide. Obviously, since its main feature is movement, it's best utilized at in-person events like cons, LARP, or Ren Faire. It's the kind of thing where when you assemble it once, you kind of just know how to do it. It's really easy to take apart and put back together again. All of the segments are exactly identical, so there's no order to them. The only thing you have to make sure is that the wire doesn't get bent, and it's really easy to put it kind of anywhere in your suitcase. Plus, they have extra wires in case you do damage one. I think the main annoying thing about the tail for me was that I kept forgetting that the wire pops out if you try and move the tail on a vertical axis. It's honestly not bad if you just remember to hold that part down with your thumb, like it tells you to, but I also kind of found a solution for this by just tying the end of the strings over the wire so it doesn't move. But like otherwise, the tail is just extremely straightforward. It's super easy to detach if you want to sit or just don't want to fuss with it anymore. The cable it comes with is pretty long, and the power bank lasts a good long while and is pretty easy to hide too. It also didn't occur to me until later that I could swap out the harness for a belt. I was really focused on the magnets and the moving and stuff, but here it is on a belt that would have matched my outfit much better. This one actually also has a pouch that makes it really easy to hide the battery pack too. For the other looks, it's kind of just stuffed into my corset. It's really easy to hide anywhere, but I still wish I had thought of this sooner. The tail is pretty light, so honestly you can use whatever kind of harnessing system you want to. Here's also a better look at the pause mode. I really like that the tail is kind of random and twitchy. It just feels very real. It's not over the top, it's not distracting, it's just your tail. You'll really want to make sure that the wire is tight and the tail has a slight curve to it, and that the strings are tight. This will give you the best results. And again, when you walk with it, remember that the electronics box is programmed to move with your shifting weight. A good way to get a feel for this is to stand and just shift your weight from side to side, really putting your knees into it. Once you get the hang of it, it's pretty easy to focus on that, and as you walk, really get the tail to move with you. They also have a really good troubleshooting video for tips if you're having any issues. Something I didn't realize until watching that video is that the tail actually should sit lower on your hips. The box should kind of be right above your cape. If you wear it too high, the results aren't as good. It also comes with a shorter metal wire so that you can do a shorter tail shape with only 9 of the segments. When I'm shooting pictures, I also like that I can just turn the tail off and sort of whip it slightly to the side so that it shows up in pictures. It's super easy to make your own tails, but you can also pick some out from their shop, and they partner with a UK service for custom orders too. They even have a crafting kit that they collaborated on with Ginny D. It comes with a little 3D printed spade tail, insulation, some colored tights, and a little bit of jewelry. This kit also has a tutorial video that I was able to follow along and make a pink version of. The videos are so helpful. This is obviously a more expensive product on their site, but I think it's absolutely worthwhile just by how easy it is to remove the tail and not have to remove the harness, the fact that it comes with a rechargeable power bank instead of relying on batteries, how lightweight it is, how easy it is to assemble and travel with it, and just like generally how versatile it is. And pause mode, pause mode. I am again sponsored by COS gear, but I do really like the product and the company. They're based out of Oslo, Norway, with just a really small team of 3 engineers and 2 business people. I had a video call with marketing guy Vetle, and he was really open to all of my ideas. Honestly, they just seemed so grateful that the cosplay and TTRPG community liked their product. They really listen to feedback, and I love that they always credit the cosplayers they feature. They've also sponsored a really wide range of cosplayers with big and small followings from all kinds of different fandoms. Not every company does that, and I'm honestly just like really surprised and grateful to see a company really appreciate the community that helped propel them to success. I wouldn't have created 5 different looks and painted myself pink if I didn't think they were worth it. You can also use the code HENDOART for 10% off of your order. I'm already thinking of so many more ways to use my cosband and my cosstail, and I can't wait to see how you use them too. Until next time, I'm Hendo. Thanks for crafting with me.